Take my hand and Jersey Joe Archino back here, and we will reload as we get ready for segment two of Soccer Showdown exclusively on the Fantasy Sports Network. And first segment, we got very deep into Euro 2016, breaking down everything there is in the bracket. But now I'm very excited to talk about the Premier League because we're getting closer and closer where things start to get very interesting. We have so much news to break down, but I think kind of the thing that will define the upcoming season is the rivalry between Manchester United and Manchester City. Now, I don't think it's a surprise to anyone that this is a rivalry as it stands because of the names of the two and the proximity and the rivalry and the tension that there always is going to be and exist between the two of them. But to kind of put it all and make it the stakes even higher, you have Jose Mourinho up against Pep Guardiola. Mourinho taking over at United, Guardiola taking over at City. The animosity and just the pure rivalry and tension that exists between these two guys who we all kind of know. The two of them are the best managers in the world. It's just the way it is. Everywhere they have ever gone, they have had success. It's one thing to have success one place, but to continually repeat it and replicate it, that's what sets you apart from everyone else. And that's one thing those two individuals have certainly done. They are going to bring success to their clubs, doesn't matter what it is. Their system, their way of doing things is just different than what everyone else is doing. They think outside the box. They put their players in certain positions that no one else can, and it's what makes them who they are. But they also have had some tremendous rivalries against each other, and you put them at the helm of these two two clubs, it's as good as it gets. But the big news, and I think this summer will be an arms race between the two of them, just stockpiling players, trying to outdo the other one. Manchester United kind of gets the ball rolling where Zlatan Ibrahimovic announces that he's decided that the next place he will play is Man United. And it's a very interesting move there because I think when you look at Zlatan, he's 34 years old, but kind of like I just alluded to a minute ago, he's a guy who's had tremendous success from league to league. It's one thing to do it in one league, but to be able to sustain greatness in multiple leagues, that's not something a lot of players can do. We've seen it time and time again where a player will have a lot of success in one league, but he just can't make the jump to another one. Angel Di Maria is the first one that comes to mind. You look at a guy like that where he was an irreplaceable player for Real Madrid. He goes to Man United, and you can't even tell he's on the field at times. Then he goes to Paris Saint-Germain, a much easier league than the Premier League, and he kind of returns to that player we know that he's capable of being. But when we look at Zlatan, he's that different breed where he is just one at every level, won at every club he has been at, put up numbers, won trophies, he's done it all. And when he's slated now to play in the Premier League, a league he's never played in before, at the age of 34, I think there needs to be some questions. At his age, can he still be that difference maker? Can he match up with the physicality of the Premier League? Because the first thing that's worth mentioning is the Premier League is the hardest league in the world. It's the most competitive league in the entire world. The best two teams are over in Spain, but the best league collectively is unquestionably in England. And it's going to be a difficult transition for anyone to make, but when I look at Zlatan physically, he's a powerhouse. There's not a lot of guys who have the speed he has, are built as physical as he is, stand as tall as he does. He really is a one-of-a-kind striker. And even at the age of 34, I think physically he matches up well in the Premier League. The thing I think will make him set himself apart even more, though, is his outspokenness. He's a guy who's never afraid to shy away from making a comment, and I think that's exactly what Man United need. United have had a very flat front the last few seasons. They need that spark. They need that energy. And Zlatan is a guy who certainly always brings energy. He's the most outspoken player in the world. He always has something to say. And I think that's exactly what United need. And even with a guy like Wayne Rooney, who's done a lot of great things on the field, at times, I don't think he's shown that leadership. He's that veteran presence on United. And obviously, he is the captain of that club. But I don't think at times he's always wanted to carry that leadership mantle. Sometimes he just wants to do what he has to do, play his game, score his goals, and go home. And sometimes there's not anything wrong with that, but when you're commanding the wages that he is and you have his responsibility and roles, sometimes he needs to do a little bit more. And I do think Zlatan will help ease that a little bit. Even if Zlatan's not always being that guy scoring the goals, he can take pressure off of Rooney in certain other aspects and certainly make his life a little bit easier. But when you look at Zlatan, what fantasy value does he have? Obviously, we're all getting ready for our premier fantasy seasons, trying to build the perfect lineup, trying to build the perfect team. And does Zlatan fit into that equation? And I would say I definitely would. I just think when you look at him, you always have to go and try to trust what you've seen before. And certainly, we have seen a lot of great things from Zlatan in the past. And to think now that you're putting him in a lineup with Jose Mourinho, a guy he's worked with before, he has a very star-studded cast, and you know United's only going, oh, this is only the start of a summer of spending for them, and I think that's the best thing, that if you're just a fan and you're watching this situation just from afar, is when United does something big, City's going to do something big. When City does something big, United's going to respond. The two of them are always going to be countering one another. City announced a long time ago that Pep Guardiola was going to be taking over as their next manager. Logically, you knew that United was going to have to answer in a big way to that, and they did. The only guy that you could respond to answering the call of Pep Guardiola with is Jose Mourinho, the only guy who I think could really challenge him for Premier League supremacy. I know Leicester City won that title last season. I was a fan. I think they won it on pure class, being good collectively united. And I think that's been the biggest thing that has been lacking for these top-tier clubs in the Premier League, is the lack of unity, the lack of getting their players to buy in together and to work together. That's something Leicester City did so well, and that's why they defied 5,000-1 odds and won the league title. But it's a different breed now. As soon as Jose Mourinho and Pep Guardiola step onto a pitch, it's their league to win. It just is. It's going to be a battle between the two of them, and it's going to be a lot of fun to watch. But now when we look at Pep Guardiola, obviously his tenure kind of begins on Sunday, where he'll have his first press conference with Manchester City. His assistants will be announced, all those other things. And we've really haven't seen him bear the crest of Manchester City yet. And it's funny because they do have announced officially and unveiled their new crest. And we all kind of had seen glimpses of it. Even last season, they put it in the Etihad at times. But now it's kind of, that's the official new crest. And with the new crest comes the new manager, Pep Guardiola. And obviously, he has a lot of decisions to make. Nolito has already been committed to sign with Man City for the upcoming season. There will be guys who are out the door. I think we all expect Yaya Toure to be out of the door. I think we all expect Pablo Zabaleta to be out the door. But Pep Guardiola obviously has a tremendous amount of talent to work with coming into this situation. John Stones, some other guys have been linked to Man City, and you know they're going to be trying to bring in some more big players. It's just in their DNA. It's what they do now. But it now comes down to, how is Pep going to really kind of take that extra stepping and get the ball rolling sooner than Jose Mourinho? Because that's the thing that will separate them from each other. It's which manager can get his players to really buy into their system sooner. It's going to take both time. It just is. When you're a manager as demanding and as taxing on your players as they are, it's going to take them a lot of time to buy into the system and to get fully integrated into it. The thing that I think will set the champion apart from the other one is which manager can get their guys to really get into their system first. It does help Man City based on the fact that their players have really known since February that Pep Guardiola was going to be the new manager. Man City made the announcement official, which is very rare and you don't really see happen all that often, but they did make the announcement. It did disrupt their season, although their season really wasn't going perfectly as it was. But that did certainly help, because there really was no surprise at any point. They knew this was going to be the new guy, and I think there will be a lot of similar faces on the team from last year, and there will be a lot of new faces as well. And Pep Guardiola, his touch on the team will be the new thing, and it will be a very interesting one. And obviously, when you get ready for your Premier Fantasy season, You don't want to load up too much on players from the same team. It's just the way it is. You want to create balance and depth all over the place, although you can generally pick three players from at least one squad. And I wouldn't really have any problem with putting at least two, but any more than that, I worry a little bit. You know, if you were going to put a guy like a Kevin De Bruyne and a David Silva on your side, I think that's probably smart. If you were going to go with a guy like a Zlatan and you tried to fill out with maybe and stash a young guy like a Marcus Rashford on your side, and I think that might be interesting too, but more than two, I'm not the biggest fan of that. You want to create a little bit of balance, and I think at times when you look at it, you know what the numbers are going to be for most of these guys, and you have to look at which ones have really projected to do the most and have had the highest ceiling. And to me, when you look across both squads, if I'm targeting one guy, I think it's got to be a guy like Kevin De Bruyne, because I just look at Kevin De Bruyne based on this fact. When he left Wolfsburg, he led the Bundesliga in assists the previous season. Then when he came to Man City, he still maintained those assists, but City needed him to be more of a focal point in the offense and more in the attack, and that's exactly what he did. When you have players who show the versatile role, they can fill dual roles and do multiple things, it's a very valuable asset to have. And I think with Kevin De Bruyne, I like players who are going to be able to give me a little bit of everything, and he certainly does that. Even a striker like a Sergio Aguero, who has the fastest goal per minute in Premier League history, you know he's going to give you the goals, but he's a guy who struggled remarkably to stay healthy. He's really had injury troubles almost every season that you could go back and remember. And even with that, he doesn't always create chances for his teammates. When I get a guy like a Kevin De Bruyne, I have a guy whose confidence scoring has been bigger. I have a guy who's being asked to be more of a focal point in the attack. And I have a guy who's always going to be creating chances for his teammates. So I kind of get a little bit of everything with a Kevin De Bruyne. And when I look across both squads, that's a very valuable asset for me to have. And you're going to go throughout the Premier League, go down the rosters. And the interesting thing and the fun thing is there's still so much that needs to happen before we can fully even sink our teeth into anything. There's still, I mean, these squads are going to look entirely different in 2 months than they do right now. It's just the nature of the game. It's the way that the offseason takes its course. And I think more than anything, you're going to want to see how do things change with the new managers, because Kevin De Bruyne did do that last year, but does Pep Guardiola have a different vision in mind for him? I wouldn't think so, because Kevin De Bruyne is a very smart player. He could adjust to anything he's asked to do, and I think that's one of the advantages of having a player like that, and why signing him for the amount of money that they did, it was worth it, because you can't find a lot of players like that in the world who are so willing to make the adjustments and are so adaptable from league to league. And again, I go back to that point, but it's true. It doesn't matter if you're in the Bundesliga, in Serie A, in La Liga, it is so difficult to make the jump to the Premier League. It's just the most physical league in the world, and while in some of the other leagues, the officials are going to allow a little bit more softness, they're going to allow you to take a little bit more dives and to act a little bit more diva-like, we don't like that. We don't like people to act like divas. I think that's one of the biggest things about soccer, why some traditional grizzled old fans and older generations in the U.S. can't get into it, because it's considered a soft sport. And at times, you see the argument when you see people diving, and I think we all value toughness in American society. We're built on toughness. It's something that's in our DNA. It's in our history. And when we don't see that same toughness, well, it's not as easy to get bought in. And I think with our most popular sport in the United States, the NFL, that's a sport defined by toughness. And more than anything, I don't think that there's that kind of that connotation that toughness doesn't exist in soccer. But in the Premier League, that is the toughest league that there is. I mean, you are not going to get the same quality calls. You're not going to get the same treatment. You're not going to be able to have that same diva-like mentality in the Premier League. And I think that's why Zlatan, going back to him, is kind of a perfect fit for, because he has that toughness. He's going to be able to make the adjustment because of how strong he is, how tall he stands, all those things. So the Premier League, is a league defined by toughness. It is the it is the most difficult, most competitive top to bottom. I'm going to always say there are probably seven clubs that stand above the rest and some that are really growing and going and maybe going to add to that number, like a West Ham United who continues to make large strides, Liverpool on the ascension. You know Chelsea's going to bounce back with Antonio Conte as manager, Man City, Man United. Is Leicester City now implanted as one of those sides? Arsenal, Tottenham Hotspur. And then I think you have a lot more interesting ones like Everton who are continuing to try to climb into that category. But I think when it's all said and done, this next season unquestionably will be defined by Man United and Man City, Jose Mourinho versus Pep Guardiola, the two best managers in the world going up against each other for English Premier League dominance. And I think that's going to be a lot of fun to watch. But in the third segment, as we get ready to go to a break, Neymar signs his Barcelona extension. When will he become the world's best player? I think that contract speaks volumes. His play has spoken volumes. So don't go anywhere. We're going to break that all down very soon.